What's up, y'all? This is Hussein Nasser from iGeometry, where we discuss software engineering by example. And this is our software talk, where we pick a topic, a software engineer topic, and we casually talk about it. All right, so in this topic, in this video, we will discuss the difference between a product engineer or product architect and a solutions engineer or a solutions architect. So what is the difference between the two roles? And but before we start, if you're new to this channel, consider subscribing. We have a lot of series that we put there. We talk about software engineering. We talk about we have a lot of tutorials that we put out. I specialize in GIS technology, but I talk about software engineering in general. So check out the other content of this channel to become a better software engineer. With that, let's just jump into the video. All right, so product engineer versus solutions engineer. What are the difference between the two? Before we jump into that, we actually need, I think, to define what is a product and what is a solution. And that's, I think, where the confusion is where it actually lies. And a lot of people confuse the two things, right? So a product and a solution are completely different. Like, they are related, but they are different. So, and based on that, we can actually define the roles of a product engineer or a solutions engineer or architect. You can just replace those roles with different developer, right? Architect. So a product in general is a software, essentially, or from a software perspective, is a software that you design and you build that solve a single problem, right? Examples. PostgreSQL, it's a product. Kafka, it's a product. PostgreSQL solves a problem of storage and retrieval and consistency and ACID in general, right? Atomicity, consistency, isolation. Check out the video here. What about ACID? Kafka, streaming services, right? How to stream messages, pops up, all that stuff, right? It's a product that solves a problem, okay? But as a customer, if you think about a customer of an industry, right, the electric industry, right, the electric utilities or water utilities or government, right, they cannot just take Postgres and just plug it, right? They need to actually solve a problem, usually streamline an entire workflow. Can you see my hand? Yeah. Streamline an entire workflow, make sure it's smooth. They need first to identify a problem in their business, right? Business, it's business related, right? And then start plugging in different products to make up a solution, right? So that's what the solution is. A solution is essentially a product, could be one, right? Could be one product out of the box, could be a customization of a product, can be a configuration of a product, could be a set of different products together put into a solution and mashed up with their custom code that is written on top to make things work to, guess what, solve a specific business industrial problem, right, for a given customer. So usually if you build a solution, it works for certain users, very specific users, right? So because you build it based on requirements, you build requirements from the user and you have to make those users happy. All right, so that's the difference, product, solution. Make sense? Right, hope you're clear. If you have any questions, ask me that there. But now comes to the roles. Who is a product engineer and who is a solution engineer? What's the difference between the two, right? A solution or a product engineer, right? Or a product architect, let's go a little level higher. A product architect is that person who sits down and actually design, right, the product. So if I am the one who designed Postgres, that guy's so smart, I'm not close to his intellect, but is that guy who sit down and then, or girl, right, girl that sat down and then just decided to design this narrow thing. Like, I want a system or a product that does this. Stores solve certain problem, very small problem usually, right? MongoDB is another product, right? So it solves certain different problems, right? So you see, and you sit down, that product architect will sit down and put all the architectural designs in that product and make sure it actually works, right? And he designs, basically she designs that product, puts that, okay, I want this to happen, I want this, I want these kind of thing to happen. I want, for example, the vacuum period to be this time because of before every single decision that the designer or the architect of the product makes will influence the actual final product, right? And this goes into iterative approach, right? Kafka, for example, the decision to make it like if you go to a message pub, right? If you subscribe to a topic, you read a message, you want to make sure that is actually you read that message once, right? That design or that even requirement is put by that person essentially. So that's the architect, right? So the product architect. A solution architect, right, is the person who sits down and takes the customer's requirement, right, or the person you're developing that solution to, and then sit down and try to build a fleet of or kind of integrate different products to solve a problem. That person can decide, it says, you know what, I'm not gonna use any out of the box product, I'm gonna build everything from scratch, right? For you, I'm gonna customize this, the database, I'm gonna build custom, I'm gonna build the web services to be custom, the intermediate middleware to be custom, everything, build it custom from scratch, right? That could be a decision. That could be fine, right? It depends on there are always trade-offs, right? So that's the general differences between a product architect and a software solution architect. And then you go down and says, okay, what's the difference between a product engineer and a solutions engineer? So we talked that the architect actually do the high level designs. The engineers test the stuff, make sure the quality of the work is at a maximum, right? So those engineers actually test this. Is the solution engineer test the entire solution? The product engineer test that product, tries. These guys get paid to find bugs, right? Their main job is to find bugs in the software and make sure the quality is up, right? Those guys also tend to understand the system the most. The engineers, it's a product engineer, understand that product ins and out. Usually product engineers also specifies into an area of that product, right? So you can go into a niche of that product if the product is big, right? So you can specialize into, for example, if it's Postgres, it will be PostgreSQL. It will be, for example, the product, there will be a product engineer responsible for tracing or logging, for example, or tracing on logging. There will be another product engineer responsible for transaction management and so on, right, guys? So, and the solutions engineer, those guys actually, there could be divided per product. If you divide your solutions into multiple products, each solution engineer can understand, there could be a solution engineer to understand the whole thing. It's really hard to do, right? Usually you can't be like a jack of all trades, right? Or master or none, right? So you have to be focused on one thing, and you pick one thing and you be really good at it. Usually that's the good idea, but you could be like, you could know multiple things, and that's okay as well. But the general idea is like, it's good to to be a really, really good at one thing only. That being said, just because you have a title of a software engineer or product architect doesn't mean that's your only job. Usually, I think I would say confidently 80% of the companies out there will use their engineers into multiple capacity. You'll wear many hats essentially, and almost any company, and that's actually a good thing if you think about it, right? So a product engineer could actually write code as a developer, right? If a product engineer wants to kind of change their career path to be a developer more than a tester, they can do that. Or the product engineer can, for example, pull back from testing and start designing products or solutions, then becomes a solutions engineer or a solutions architect, right? Depends on what are you trying to do? Where are you trying to reach, right? And you reach there by actually practicing, right? Reading books, getting theoretical is good, but the only way to advance in software engineering is by just doing it, right? You see a problem, you see something needs automating, you go and automate it, right? Okay, you can look for things that are out there, people who already automated stuff, that's okay, you can pick up from other people's work, but to really learn, you actually have to do the work. You have to do the work yourself. That's just an advice. So, summary, a product engineer is the person who designs a product or a software that does one and only one thing and it does it really well. And a solutions engineer is that engineer who pulls up together different products, right? From down to the database, the storage mechanism, to the middleware, down to the application, whether it's iOS app, mobile app, any mobile app really, Android, web, and it tries to basically complete the whole picture, right? To provide a service or a solution to a given customer. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed this episode. Please subscribe if you like this video. Give it a like and comment if you have any questions. And I'm gonna see you in the next one. Stay awesome.